Peaceful protesters in Washington, D.C.'s Lafayette Park were sent scrambling earlier this week as riot police fired what is commonly considered as tear gas into the crowd. The move is being criticized by police watchdog groups and health officials who say the use on civilians can lead to increased health risks, including coronavirus. On Friday, Seattle's mayor banned police from using one type of tear gas. Roxana Saberi has more on how this wartime chemical drifted from the battlefield to the streets.
We're in a war zone.
From Portland and Minneapolis to just outside the White House, tear gas is sending protesters fleeing with their eyes watering and skin burning.
It's supposed to be non-lethal.
Hamish DeBreton Gordon is a chemical weapons expert.
It is very effective at breaking up crowds and stopping rioting. However, it also produces horrific injuries and in a small number of cases, deaths as well.
Tear gas was intended for combat. Its first known use was to drive enemy troops from the trenches in World War I. Amos Fries, an American general in the war, thought the weapon could serve a purpose in peacetime, too.
The general literally donated military samples to friends of his, who then started these sort of entrepreneurial companies.
Anna Feigenbaum is the author of a book on the history of tear gas.
They were able to convince law enforcement that they needed to have tear gas on hand at all times in case there were protests.
Since then, there have been many times tear gas has filled the streets of America. When veterans marched on Washington in 1932. In the 1960s, to quell civil rights marches, student protests, and opposition to the Vietnam War. And in recent decades, tear gas has become a familiar part of protests in places like Hong Kong, Gaza, and France. That's even though it's considered a chemical weapon, banned from use in international warfare since 1993.
It is generally left up to each individual country to have their own laws in this particular area. It is probably about time that the United Nations took a lead here to develop legislation that this stuff is used as safely as possible.
And critics say tear gas poses an even bigger danger these days, because by causing coughing and sneezing, it could help spread COVID-19. For CBS This Morning Saturday, Roxana Saberi, London.
Interesting history. And Jeff, also, we've seen so many mayors out there encouraging people, if they've been a part of protests, to go and get tested for COVID-19 because of all of this.
Yeah, not a bad idea, and an interesting conversation to have.